think everybody has realized by now that using AI to help with your writing can really speed the process along. But unfortunately, it also makes your writing a little bit bland and boring, and sometimes it's just so obvious that something was written with AI. So what is the solution to this? Of course, it is more AI. That's why I'm excited to check out Humanize AI, which is supposed to take your writing, your blog posts, and just make it undetectable that you ever used AI in the first place. Now, this is currently available on AppSumo as a lifetime deal. I picked up tier one to make this video. If you want to grab a copy of Humanize for yourself, you can check my link down below in the description. Thank you to everybody who's supporting this channel by clicking on my link before making a purchase at AppSumo. So here is what Humanize looks like. We get several tools here. It looks like about seven tools. We've got our AI article agent for SEO and AEO. There's an AI writer, of course, which is inspired by Notion. We've got our AI detector to be able to tell whether or not something was written with AI. There's a plagiarism checker, a grammar checker, as well as a paraphraser. Now, I just asked Grok to write me an article about the future of self-hosted software. It honestly did a better job than I expected. AI writing has really come a long way in the last 6 months. There's no very clear indications like, I hope this article finds you well as the opening, but I'm gonna go ahead and run this through their AI detector and see if it can even tell it was written by AI. So inside the tool, I'll go to the AI detector and then I'm just gonna paste in my article. This was 100% written with Grok. I'm gonna hit check AI detection and we'll find out what it says. All right, so the AI detector says 74% written with AI. Now we should be able to humanize this, run it through the detector again, and then hopefully it says 0% written by AI. So I'm gonna go to the humanize section over here. I'll paste in the exact same article unchanged and just hit humanize. That's all there is to it. All right, now on the right, we have the updated version. All of the changes that were made are highlighted in green. So I can copy this. We'll go back over to the AI detector, paste this in here, and we'll check for AI after having run it through the humanizer. And now it says only 3%. Pretty impressive. Of course, that's just one small component of the tool, but I think it's a very practical use case. Now, the thing that most people are probably coming to this tool for and potentially buying a large plan on AppSumo, tier three or something like that, is the AI plus AEO article agent. So I'm just gonna give it a prompt very similar to what I gave to Grok, actually, just asking for an article on the future of self-hosted software. I'll hit submit here and we'll see what it comes up with. So the interface for this is very ChatGPT-esque. It looks like I'm in an actual conversation. It asks me what type of article do I want. Narrative blog is what it chose for me, and I actually think that is the best option, but I could also do a how-to guide or listicle. You get the idea. So I'm gonna hit confirm here and move to the next step, which is to choose my target audience. I want to rank in the United States. I'm gonna use the auto SERP tone. I'll do SEO optimization, AEO optimization, and humanized writing. In the next step, it's asking for backlinks. Now I can have it find its own sources by just clicking the web sources checkbox here, or research checkbox if I prefer that, or I can include custom links if I know I want to cite a particular piece of work. For now, I'm just going to have it find its own and hit confirm. Next, it's asking if I want to provide any additional guidance or details, and I'm just going to say nothing more at this point, but it's a nice step to actually ask for some custom instructions for the article. All right, nothing more, and I'll hit send. Moving on to keywords, it found some keywords that it's suggesting for me. This future of self-hosted software seems like the best fit. Unfortunately, there's no volume on self-hosted software, and that's a legitimate reality that we live in. I'm gonna go ahead and select this keyword and move on to the next one. Next up, they're asking who your competitors are. It's automatically selected the top five results, but I could add in a custom URL if I prefer. I'm gonna save these competitors and proceed. All right, now we're moving on to the next section, it says, which is secondary keyword research. It just kind of stopped and it's asking me to say something, I think. So I'll just type in go ahead and we'll hit send. Sometimes that happens with AI. It just kind of loses its place and you need to persuade it to continue working. Everything went fine after I told it to go ahead, and we've got the next option, which is our secondary keywords. So it gave me some long tail keywords here like self-hosted software, future of home security systems. That one doesn't sound very good. Let's get rid of that. Future of self-driving, future of software development, 2023, and future of self-storage. Now I can add in my own long tail keywords right up here by clicking on the add button and just typing it in. There are some keyword variations at the bottom, and those look a lot better than the long tail keywords that it gave me. So I'm gonna go ahead and proceed here. Next up is the title, and it gave me three options to choose from. I do like the first one that it selected, but I think the last one is a little bit better. Future of Self-Hosted Software 2025, what's next for users? All right, we're gonna select that title. If I didn't like it, I could have it generate some new ones, but I think that one looks pretty good. Let's proceed to the next step. In the next step, it's determining the optimal article length. It determined that 1844 is the optimal length. It's asking if I want to proceed. I said yes, and then we move on. So I can see all the work it's doing. It's doing a bunch of searches to kind of get some recon going here. It's all stuff that humans would do. It would just take us a lot longer. All right, now my outline is complete. I've got a list of headlines over here. It's gonna be a pretty beefy article. There's quite a few headlines. It's asking if I want to make any changes or if I'm ready to approve it. I think it looks pretty good. If I found a topic that I wanted to add in, I could just ask the AI to add in a specific topic and it would do so. And you know what? I am gonna ask it for a change. I want a section on control panels, software that lets you launch self-hosted software very easily without a lot of technical background. It also makes it easier to host it long-term, do maintenance and things like that. So I'm gonna ask it for that update and we'll see what it does. So in the chat here, it says it added the section on control panels to the outline. I don't actually see it. It asks if I want any more changes or if I'm ready to approve the outline. I'm just gonna say that I don't see the change, but otherwise I'm ready to go. And send, and it is going to progress to content. All right, here it is writing the article in front of me in real time. Looks like it's going to be pretty lengthy. Remember the predicted amount was 1,844. We're already up to about 1,000 words here. There are some toggles at the top for your metadata. That would be your title and description. We've got some structured data so that you can get Google snippets. And then there are also your social media links here, like your OG images, your Twitter images, and things like that. The article and schema has been generated and saved. So we can scroll through here and actually read our article. I am very curious to find out if the panels make it in, and they sure did. All right, that's awesome. It's always good when AI listens to you and does what it says it's going to do. And we do have a very SERPer SEO style score option over here where I can see the SEO score, the AEO score, and then we've got our content quality. Looks like the title is maybe a weak spot. We've got our structure and our keyword optimization. The article did end up being about 2,100 words, so it overshot our goal by just a little bit. I don't think that's enough to be penalized. I think it's probably a pretty good length. And then we are ready to go here. We can export this to DocX. That is really our only option for, you know, publishing this. It might be nice to have Markdown or just some other options. I suppose you could always copy and paste. One weakness that jumps out to me right away is the fact that it does not do any sort of image generation. So you're just gonna get a huge block of text and then you'll need to fill in your images later on. Now you can add images to the article themselves. We can click on the image icon up here, but there's no integrations with any sort of stock photography library like Pixabay or Pexels or any of those where you can just choose some stock photography. That's fine. I mean, the internet has enough articles like that already, but I think something would definitely be nice. The editor is super easy to use here. It's the Lexical editor, which is an open source editor from Facebook. It's the same one that the Ghost CMS uses, which is my favorite CMS. So we get slash commands here, just like in Notion. We've got some cards to choose from. There's also Markdown supported. So if I wanted to add in a heading, I could just hit the pound, then hit space, and now I've got a heading one. If I wanted a heading two, I'd do two pound signs, so on and so forth. There are two AI functions built in. We've got AI Writer as well as Ask AI. So with the Ask AI function, I can select some text and then I get the Ask AI button up here or over here. I'll do the same thing. There's a key command, Command J. So I'll press that and then I get some options to continue writing, to create an outline. You get the idea. It's ways to beef up that section of writing. The AI Writer option opens the document inside of the full AI Writer. Just a little less distraction. We don't have that chat box on the side. We still can do everything that we saw before. There is a little scrollable table of contents up here, so that makes it really easy to go to a specific section, but otherwise just a little bit less distracting. Now, all of your articles will live in the AI Writer tool, which is just right over here. If I click on this, I can see my existing article. There's a folder system, so I could go ahead and organize my documents if I wanted as well. So here's a folder, and I can simply drag and drop my article into that folder to get things organized. There are some other tools here that are grayed out. They are not available yet. They're called the AI Content Optimizer, the AI Monitor, and the AI Crawler Traffic. It's kind of hard to see here. There it is, the AI Crawler Traffic. These will all be coming later. I don't believe they'll be included in the AppSumo plan, but I'm not certain. Some final thoughts on Humanize AI. It's a very intuitive and easy to use application. Generating articles takes little time at all, but it's not super fast. It doesn't feel rushed like it's just trying to give you as many articles as possible. You have a lot of control throughout the process, and I like that. A few things that I think need improvement are, one, we just need some more export options, maybe some integrations with tools to publish directly inside of the application. That would go a long way for sure. The other thing is just images. Like I already mentioned, it's hard to get images into your article. You'd have to kind of have them all on your desktop already and then drag them in throughout the article where it seems like it's necessary. It would be good for their optimization tool or whatever is giving me the score to let me know how many images need to be added. That was also something that is seemingly important for SEO, so something they could keep an eye on. Overall, I give Humanize AI a 6.8 out of 10. It's a nice tool. It does the job very well. I think it's really best for people who want precise control over their article generation, but we are all swimming in so many AI tools. It just doesn't really solve a problem that I think most of us have right now, other than the people that are really relying on SEO and AEO for their traffic. That's gonna do it for this video. If you've liked the video, hit the like button. Subscribe if you're new around here. Click my AppSumo link before making a purchase. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next review.